I got realness, I just kill shit, cause it's in my DNA. I got millions, I got riches building in my DNA. I just win again, then win again like...
Yo, what up, guys? It's your boy, Sun TJ, here to review Dragon Ball Super Episode 98. Excuse me if this review comes out a little bit later. I caught this at like 10 o'clock, so it might come out later. Man, this episode is very action-packed. I really enjoyed it. And we're only two episodes away from Episode 100, man. Like, Dragon Ball Super has come a long way. And I know a lot of people got aggravated that I mentioned the reuses of the animations from previous episodes. I was just making an observation. It wasn't really a big deal to me. I was just afraid that, you know, they was going to just completely just rely on old animations instead of new ones. But it's a lot more new animations and art in this episode, which I really enjoyed. And most of this episode is just Goku taking on Universe 9, then Vegeta stepping in as well. And the thing that irked me the most about this episode was Whis and Beerus's statements. Like, Beerus calling the trio of danger weak, and I'm like, one of the guys can use Goku's power all the way up to Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken, but I guess they wanted to retcon it and say that pretty much Bergamo and them can't really fuck with Goku and Vegeta if they go all out. And and also Whis keeps stating over and over again that he doesn't imagine Goku and Vegeta teaming up or whatever. Like, Goku and Vegeta have teamed up so many times, and it's already been proven in the fucking Future Trunks saga that Goku and Vegeta have teamed up. So yet again, the Whis and Beerus statements are kind of not reflecting the story, in my opinion, at this point. And also, Whis keeps stating that Super Saiyan Blue uses up so much stamina. Like, Goku and Vegeta have been using Blue instantly and barely feeling any effects. Like, those statements work in the manga because they keep hassling about it, but Whis keeps mentioning that Blue uses up a lot of stamina. That is annoying because it really does it. So yet again, them keep mentioning that and just saying Goku and Vegeta don't know how to work together, it's not reflecting the story, and it's kind of getting aggravating at this point. Also, the aura that everyone kept on making videos about, it just ended up being a barrier. You know how Vegito made a barrier before being absorbed by Buhan and shit like that? So it's just a barrier to defend him from Lavender's poison. So yeah, that was actually pretty cool. We're not going to see Ultimate Goku just yet because everyone thought that was going to be the Ultimate aura. But yeah, they actually was pretty cool. We saw some cool fights in between and just seeing all of Universe 9 and people. And also another thing was the guy with the iron skin. I'm like, I don't know if just being iron, like, I guess that's just a name. Like, it doesn't really reflect, you know, the type of defense he has. But I don't know. It's just some stuff they're trying to make the characters seem like the story is really trying to make Goku and Vegeta seem like they're in danger, but they're really not that much in danger right now. Like, trying to make it sound like Blue is really wearing out their stamina, or this guy with iron defense, really Goku can't punch through him, stuff like that. But the tide changes when both Goku and Vegeta go Super Saiyan and they pretty much wreck. Then when they finish off Universe 9, because Universe 9 is getting wrecked, like, they're losing people left and right once Goku and Vegeta take it upon themselves to attack when their guard is down. And it was really cool seeing the final Kamehameha again, except Vegeta goes Super Saiyan Blue, final Flash, then Goku goes Kamehameha Super Saiyan Blue, and you just see the final Kamehameha destroy them. Then we also see Frieza. He was torturing one of the Universe 9 guys to make him leave the tournament, so Frieza just had to kill him. He just makes him want to leave. And we just see that the two Xenos instantly destroy the universe without even fucking trying, just a flick of the wrist. So Xeno and them are easily multi-universal. They don't give a fuck. And just seeing Universe 9's Angel with an evil smile, not giving a fuck about the universe. Like, and it's weird because that same Angel looked pissed off when he saw how the universe was, where it was destroyed, it was dismantled. Like, just seeing the state of the planet they was at, and now to see him look all evil, it was kind of a big character flip, in my opinion. But yeah, that's most of the episode. Just some more new animation, but they're still using old animation to keep this episode nice and pretty, because it does look really nice. I'm just glad that they're keeping up with the art and they're staying on model. And the fighting was pretty cool. I just the things that's irked me is just Whis keep going back on these statements saying that he doesn't imagine Goku and Vegeta working together, or Blue is using up a lot of stamina. I'm like, fuck off, Whis. I'm sorry, but fuck off with them statements, because they're using Blue left and right and no stamina drain really at all. Next episode preview is episode 99, which it seems like Krillin is going to be fighting this bird fucker. And Android 18 is about to get in some type of trouble when she gets teamed up on or with Frost coming in. And because Frost is really powerful, so he might actually will give Android 18 a challenge. And it seems like she's got her sunglasses as well. So I'm guessing Krillin's going to unleash like the super solar flare, and she's going to have the her shades to protect her from it. And yeah, man, I don't want to say any spoilers because there's been a shitload of spoilers uploaded by Geek the 101. So I kind of know a lot was going to happen. Well, it always changes later on. So for this episode, I'll give it a solid 7 out of 10 or an 8 out of 10. Really enjoyed it. Just those two things irked me. It's just the Beerus statements and the Whisk statements. They're just contradicting the story. Tell me what you guys think about this episode. And let me know if you want me to do any live reactions of Dragon Ball Super. I will make sure to upload on my second channel. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do with my second channel, because I'm growing a lot more just doing what I regularly do. Live stream, gaming, reviewing, and just doing what I want. I gain more subscribers, so... yet again. Also, my fanfiction class, once we I'm going to start putting like marks on it, because I want to keep spamming y'all with fanfiction class. If we consistently get 40 likes on each of my videos, and I'll continue uploading those videos. So just, we're almost at 37 likes on my fanfiction class on the previous one. If you want another one, get that video to 40 likes and you got a deal. So yeah, man, if you like the video, man, like the video. Sun to job, peace, love you all.